Good afternoon, Liberty High School, and welcome back to KLHS. I'm Cadence Brower, and today is Thursday, December 8th.
Hey there, everyone. I'm Maureen Gable, and we've got a great show in store today.
We'll start off with a top story from Blair Baymiller over Brittany Griner getting freed.
I didn't know she got freed, and that's so amazing, and I can't wait to hear all about it.
After that, we'll head to Libby to get the weather report.
Can't wait to see what the weather looks like for the rest of the week, because I hope it does not include rain. And finally, we'll close out with a segment from Claire over the court-warming theme.
I love court-warming, so that will be super fun to hear all about. With that being said, make sure you sit back and relax, because this is KLHS. Now, Morgan, we know there is lots of world news happening right now.
Most definitely, Cadence. Our world is changing so fast.
The most recent news today revolves around prisoner in Russia, Brittany Griner.
Let's head over to our reporter, Blake Baymiller, for more information.
What's up, Jays? Happy Thursday. Let's get right into our top story today. As I'm sure most of you have heard, Russia freed Brittany Griner in a prison exchange. President Joe Biden tweeted earlier today, "I spoke to Brittany Griner. She is safe. She is on a plane. She is on her way home." Griner, who has been detained in Russia for 294 days, was serving a 9-year sentence and was recently relocated to a penal colony in Mordovia, about 210 miles outside of Moscow. Griner, a WNBA, NCAA, and Olympic champion, had been detained in Russia since being arrested in February on charges that she brought vape cartridges carrying a small amount of cannabis oil into the country. Griner has been freed on a high-level prison exchange with the United States, releasing notorious Russian arms dealer Viktor Bout, who was serving a 25-year sentence after he was convicted of conspiring to kill Americans, supplying anti-aircraft missiles, and of aiding a terrorist organization.
I think it was a really interesting decision to trade a arms dealer for somebody who doesn't really have any political affiliation or anything.
So much for that insight. Make sure to go to LHS_KLHS on Twitter and vote on our poll and voice your opinion on the release of Brittany.
Thank you, Blair.
I'm so glad to hear she's home safe and sound.
With that, let's shift the focus on to some announcements.
First up, we have open slots for Edge Micro School next school year. If you are interested in project-based learning, go online and fill out the application. If you're still on the Edge, there is an information session happening tonight at 6 p.m. in the View. Do not miss out if you have any questions. Please make sure you take advantage of this opportunity. Next up, we have a Spirit Week leading up to Finals Week. The time period for this will be all of next week, starting next Monday, December 12th, and remaining until next Friday, December 16th. Make sure you deck out in your comfy clothes and pajamas all week long.
Moving on, the prices of the yearbook will increase from $60 to $65 on January 1st of the next year. We are proud to say that we have sold already over 700 books. You do not want to be left out. Last year we ran out of books, so hopefully you get in the scoop and get some. You can purchase them on yearbookforever.com to purchase. Also, if you are a senior or senior parent wishing to purchase a senior ad, we have three left, so make sure you get one and email Jamie Munoz if interested. And finally, our last announcement of the day, Liberty High School now has a Connect 30 for Instagram. They will give insights and updates of what is happening and what to offer during that week. The tag is at @LHSConnect30. Make sure to give it a follow when you get service. And we cannot forget a big shout out to the cheerleading team as they head out to state, wishing them the best of luck.
That is all the announcements we have to cover today.
Was it just me, or when you were walking in, it was raining?
You know, Morgan, I wish I could say it wasn't, but sadly it was.
Hopefully it does not last the rest of the week. So let's head to Liberty Hearst to get the scoop.
Hello everyone, I'm Libby Hearst here to explain the weather to you. For the next 4 days, including today, the weather is surprisingly consistent. Most of you noticed the mist when you were going to school. That will continue and transform into possible light showers. It'll be around 46 during the day and 31 at night. Also, there's a 70% chance of rain. Following that, Friday, December 9th, the low is 32 and the high is 46. It'll be partly cloudy and a 60% chance of rain at night. Now heading to the weekend. On Saturday, the low will be 29 and the high will be 48. Light showers will start in the morning, followed by a 40% chance of rain, and it will be partly cloudy. Now finishing up on Sunday, there will be a 29, the low will be 29, and the high will be 48. Plus there's a mix of sunshine plus clouds, and then it'll turn into partly cloudy in the evening. That is the end of this weather segment. I hope you enjoy this. Bye-bye.
What is up, Jays? I am here with our STU co-executive president, Carly Loomis, and we are going to talk about some court warming information. So first of all, Carly, when is court warming?
The court warming dance is Saturday, January 14th from 7:30 to 10:30 p.m.
All right, that is awesome. We're going to jump in straight to the most wanted answered question. What is the court warming theme this year?
The 2023 court warming theme is Snowed In, a Blue Jay Blizzard.
So what is that going to be like? What is the vibe? What are the decorations going to look like?
I think we're going for more like a ski lodge vibe with like a fireplace. And then there's also going to be like snow, snowflakes, and that kind of stuff too.
Okay, that is really exciting, Blue Jays. I hope you are excited. Is there any more information that we should know?
I would just say keep looking in your email and on Twitter and Instagram and thing, because stuff will be released soon.
All right, so you heard it here. More information will be released here soon, maybe even on KLHS. And that's all I have for today. So for KLHS, this has been Claire Hamilton signing off.
Thank you, Claire and Libby, for those segments.
I am very excited for court warming and hope the weather will improve throughout the week.
Couldn't have said any better myself. Now our show is almost finished, but before you go, can everyone please stand for the pledge?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Big thanks to Blair Bay Miller,
Libby Hurst,
Claire Hamilton,
and the rest of our amazing behind-the-scenes production crew. For KLHS, this has been Morgan Gable
and Cadence Breyer.
Have a terrific Thursday, Jays.